So the negative value of current when voltage is the same, when you don't change the polarity of voltage or anything like that, then negative value of current actually means negative power. Then the question is, but what is negative power? Well, negative power simply means opposite direction of a power flow. So if you had one direction and now you're getting negative, that means it just flows in opposite direction. Negative power can happen with both active and reactive power. So it can happen with both, but what it really means is it just flows in opposite direction. So here are a couple of examples. So if you have negative power consumption, that really means that you have power generation. So normally for cap bank, we say cap banks generate reactive power. It is same as saying cap bank consumes negative reactive power. So those two sayings are, you can say, equivalent. You can also have, for example, a battery that is being charged. So normally battery is considered to be a generator, so the power flows away from the battery. But if you're charging a battery, then the power flows into the battery. So then you have negative power generation. And negative power generation is simply same as power consumption. Okay, so normally on a transmission line, you have, at least in AC system, you have active and reactive power flows. That positive and negative power flow or positive or negative power can occur just the same with P as with Q. I'm giving you here a transmission line and I designated S as sending end of transmission line and R as receiving end of transmission line. Now, that could be a feeder. It could be distribution line. That doesn't matter. In high voltage system where you have a lot of sources and a lot of loads, you have basically a grid of lines, then saying that one end is sending end and the other end is receiving end doesn't really have much sense. But we sometimes, for example, calculation reasons, we tend to designate everything on one end as sending end or with subscript S. And then on the other end, we use subscript R. But if power flow changes, then sending may become receiving and receiving may become sending. So in that case, you can also designate line with simply A and B. Also within same transmission line, you can have maybe sending end sending power to the receiving end in the morning and then goes the other way in the afternoon. Be it as it may, what I'm trying to say is if you have two points in the power system, you can have active power in the same direction as reactive power, or they can be opposite. Those are all four, you can say, combinations that you can have with those two powers. And again, what you're going to consider plus and what you're going to consider minus is basically up to you. And if I say this is my sending end and this is my receiving end, that means that the power that flows over this line, I expect to flow from S towards R, and that would be, let's say, my positive. So in this case, P is positive, Q is positive. Here, P is positive, Q is negative. Or P is negative, Q is positive, and P and Q are both negative. So again, it becomes a question of your reference or your convention as to what you normally assume as positive. The power will flow as it flows. The power by itself is not positive or negative. Being positive means the actual flow is in the direction of assumed flow. Being negative means the actual flow is in the opposite direction of assumed flow. And I'm talking here powers, but exactly the same holds for currents. As a matter of fact, the same holds for voltages as well. If you look within one cycle, the voltage flips as well. So what is positive, what is negative, is just a matter of reference, or what is my assumed direction or polarity. Normally, we have the choice to pick a reference. So normally, our reference is from S towards R, and then we obtain these powers positive. But if we pick the opposite direction from R to S or B to A, then these would be negative. But it would be actually the same power flows. Again, the convention that you use or what you assume becomes important.